This is the GivEnergy EV Charger. Yes, it really does exist out in the wild. I've been sent this as part of their beta program to try and make sure that it's perfect, ready for the proper release later this year. To start with, let's go and have a look what was in the box when it arrived. Well, here it is then. This is the elusive GivEnergy EV charger that has been a long time coming. So let's have a look and see what's inside. A lot of this is going to be me removing packaging, so probably won't be that interesting. Whoa, it's a bit of foam. Okay, we've got a wall bracket. Just put stuff down here out of the way. A certificate of approval and an Allen key. More foam. Okay, a whole bunch of screws and wall plugs and washers. Okay, this is all joined together. So you can see you've got the actual type 2 plug sitting on the top attached to the cable, which is going inside the charger itself. So I'm gonna have to pick the whole thing out of the box to be able to show you. Let's put that down there on the table. And we've also got this. If I can show that a bit closer, it's a holder and something to hold the charge cable in. It's actually more compact than I thought it was. I mean, just to hold it up there, it's not that big. It's smaller than the pod point. I should probably do a side-by-side comparison photo at some point. But yeah, it's quite a compact little charger. Ah, that is what the key's for. You can't get inside without the Allen key. So that obviously opens up this bit here. Yeah, very interesting viewing this. Opening a screw, that pops off. More screws, show you in there. You've got another cover just there with some twisty screws. That pops off. And that's where you connect it all. Okay. That's at this point that you can't see much, so I'm going to go and get that camera and show you what's in there. So there it is. It's quite a dinky little unit by comparison to my pod point, as I said before. If I zoom in, you can clearly see just there is where you would put the input power. So you've got live, neutral and PE. I'm guessing the L2 and L3 terminals are for if you had, I don't know, three phase. This is definitely a single phase model, so I guess the three phase must be coming soon. And over there you've got the connections that go out to the actual type 2 connector. There's a little orange terminal block just there, so I can zoom out to get a bit of a focus on it. That's where the CT clamp would go. Well, it's actually an EM115 meter, so data terminals going to EM115, and then a port there for Ethernet. That's RJ45 socket. Obviously on the front of it you've got the now famous GivEnergy design, which shows you in lights where the energy is coming from or going to. In this case you've got grid, PV or car. Now I've just noticed these things attached to the cable, and they're both numbered and they've got little key ring hole punches in them. I think that these are RFID tags, because I do know that this charger's got an RFID reader built into it. You can see that little wireless symbol just there. I think that's where the reader is, just under there. And the idea is you can use these RFID tags like keys. So if you want to give someone permission to use your charger, you can just give them one of these and they can come along, tap it on the charger, and it should unlock it so as they can start charging.
So it's time to get it installed then. I've got an electrician coming this morning and he's going to help swap out the pod point for the GivEnergy charger. So hopefully in a couple of hours time, I'll have a working GivEnergy EV charger. Here we go, the old pod point's been taken off. We can look inside that now. And you can see it's quite a mess in there really. It doesn't look that protected. There's a lot of open wires. It's quite strange seeing the front of our house with no EV charger attached to it. We've had it there for about 3 years, so without it, it feels a little bit naked. You can see there's a little bit of residue left from the silicon that was sealing the pod point to the wall, so hopefully we'll cover up as much of that as possible with the new charger. Right, so it's all wired up and ready to commission, so let's have a go at this. I need to go to EV charger, start setup. Scan the QR code on the side. Okay, network name and password. Now I need to restart the EV charger. Okay. Two beeps is good apparently. I have restarted my charger. Did you hear EV charger beep? Yes. Okay then, the moment of truth. I think I need to turn on plug and go, and it's boost. I think that's all I need to do. Yep, and then I open this, plug in the charger. It's made a noise, it's clicked, it seems to be charging. Okay, if I look at the app itself, it now says it's charging at 7.3 kilowatts, which is what I was expecting. Well, there we go, it's all installed now, and it didn't take too long. You can see that the cable is wrapped around it nicely. I haven't got the holster stuck on the wall yet because I wanted to see what it would look like with the cable wrapped around it and where best to place the holster. You can also see there's a little bit of silicon gunk behind. I need to scrape that off to tidy it up properly. But apart from that, it's a pretty nice, smart install. Now obviously with this EV charger, it needs an EM115 meter. Now because I have the GivEnergy gateway that you can see here, there is a really nice convenient slot just for the meter. You can see there in the middle with the green display. And obviously there is a breaker right there, an RCD right there for the EV charger too. But if you don't have the gateway, you can just have that in your consumer unit or in another little box that's near the charger or wherever's convenient. Okay, and I've also got this network cable going into my network switch here because the GivEnergy EV charger, it supports wired networking as well as Wi-Fi. So you need Wi-Fi to do the initial setup process, but once you have that set up, you can connect it with a wired network cable. I've obviously got to tidy that up. That's why the cover is still off the trunk in there, because I'm going to have to run it nice and neatly through once I've finished. I've gone and installed the plug holster on the right hand side just because the way that the cable coiled naturally, it wanted to sit there. Now you can hang your cable over the top of this, that's why it's got this lip on it, I assume, but I actually think it looks quite neat just wrapped around the charger like that. So now I want to talk a bit about the charger's functionality and controlling it with the GivEnergy app. When you add the charger to your account, you can enable a new little car icon on the main page, which will show you the live power going into your car. You can access the controls for the charger by tapping your menu in the top left and choosing EV charger, which will present you with a specific dashboard just for your charger. Now, I want to stress that this dashboard is in beta, and I know for certain that it will change before it launches, and that some of the terminology will also change at some point too. So it wouldn't be fair of me to criticize any of the layouts and things. I'll save that for after it's released officially. So when I'm talking about modes like Eco and Eco Plus, they might be called something different by the time you get your hands on this, but the functionality will be very likely the same. So let's take a quick look at the EV charger dashboard then.
We have a setting here called plug and go, which basically means charge now. When this is disabled, like it is here, if you plug the car in, then it won't start charging immediately. It'll just sit there waiting until it hits a scheduled charge window. But if you wanted to charge right then and there, you turn on plug and go. Now, there are three modes you can use. The first one, called Eco Plus at the moment, will charge only from solar excess. The CT clamp will be monitoring for exported power, and if that reaches 6 amps or about 1.4 kilowatts, then it'll divert it and anything above that into your car. There's also a mode called Eco, which will basically trickle charge your car at 6 amps all the time, from the grid or your battery or wherever. If your solar export increases above that, then it'll increase the speed it charges to match. And finally, there's Boost, which doesn't care where the power comes from, it'll charge at full speed. Well, actually, it doesn't have to charge at full speed because you can adjust the speed by setting the max charge current slider here. And if you wanted to add, say, 10 kilowatt hours into your car and then stop the charge, you can set the max charge energy slider here too. Of course, you're also able to set scheduled charge times so as you can take advantage of off-peak tariffs like Octopus Go. You just add a new slot with your preferred timings, and you can also limit the charge speed on those too. There's also a handy page with your charge session data on and some useful graphs if you want to browse through those too. So as you can see, it's got all of the features you would expect from a modern EV charger, and it's considerably more advanced than my old PodPoint. GivEnergy are working on more functionality and increased integration with their existing inverters too, so I expect to see lots of surprises in future updates. Now, if you've seen my channel before, you'll know I'm a bit obsessed with Home Assistant, and local control is very much a feature of other GivEnergy products. This charger does support local control, however, at the time of putting together this video, the GivTCP add-on hasn't been updated to support it. It's coming soon though. You can use the cloud API to control it, and I have that working, but I'll need to show you that in a future video. Anyway, I hope you found this useful, and if you did, then please give the video a like, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see more from me. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.